Here we have whiskey barrel planter. Here in Maine, people use these whiskey barrels, half whiskey barrels for planters. They're excellent planters. They're durable. They last years. I personally have 10 of them that I've had for 15 years. And they allow the plants to get really big because there's a lot of soil capacity, which holds water, which means you don't have to water as much, and you have a larger root system, which means a bigger plant. Simple as that. Come with a hole in the bottom for drainage, but in general, that hole has got a cork in there when you get it. First thing you need to do is you need to pull the cork out and provide proper drainage. In this case, that hasn't happened. And another thing is you want to have your drainage holes on the sides of the barrel, simply because if you have it on the bottom and you don't have proper drainage underneath the barrel, what happens is if you get a prolonged period of rain or you overwater, the weight of the barrel itself pushes down and it doesn't allow the water to drain out the bottom. So in essence, what happens is the thing fills up with water and you get a whiskey barrel full of water. Now, what I suggest is you drill the holes on the side of the barrel. You want to drill the holes, four of them, on the sides all around the barrel. As I said, if you don't do that, the plants will look good at first. And if it never rains and you water as you normally do, they'll look good for a long time. It's when you have a prolonged period of rain that you have the problems. So we've done that. Now, next thing we want to do is we want to fill it with growing media or soil. I use a Pro Mix. It's peat moss. All it is peat moss. It comes out of peat bogs in Canada. So there's a couple of reasons why we use the peat moss. Primarily, it's sterilized. It's been heated up to 180 degrees, and that kills any kind of pathogen, any kind of bug, any kind of fungus that might be in there. And beyond that, there's no seeds for weeds, no weed seeds. So when you put it in there, the only thing that's going to grow in there is your plant. And then beyond that, it's very absorbent. A lot of people say, geez, I don't like using that potting, that Pro Mix, simply because it dries out fast. It really doesn't dry out any faster than anything else. What it does is it allows the roots to grow very rapidly. And because you have so many roots, they efficiently use the water that's in there. And that's what you want. More roots, bigger plant. This allows more roots.
Sean then adds time-released fertilizer.
Now, most greenhouses use a 3 to 4 month, including Miracle-Gro products that you buy at the box stores is a 3 month release time. Well, if you're planting your plant in April or May, we'll just say May, 3 months, May, June, July, it's depleted. So what I do is I use a landscaping version of it, and it takes you all the way to September, October. So it's a little more money, but it's worth it. Here's the trick. This is how you get your great big planter right off the bat. I'm going to use this pot to form a mold inside this whiskey barrel. And what that'll do is it'll allow me to pop off the pot that's on that hanging basket over there and put it right into that mold that I made. So I'll just show you.
Then Sean gently takes apart the hanging basket.
This is the important part. Placing your hand at the base of the plant. If you push your hand down like that, you're going to bust it all up and you ruined it. Your fingers down. Drop it down in there, and you kind of feel in there until you get to the fingers on the dirt. And I'm not pushing down on any branches, okay? And I take the thing, flip it over like that, take it to the edge of something, in this case, the four-wheel drive unit, tap it, a little tap here, and she comes out. Look at all those roots. Isn't that pretty? All right, so now we just line it up to your hole, and in one quick shot, boom, she's in there. You want to water it until it soaks right through, runs right through. And I suggest you water approximately 5 gallons with 5 tablespoons of Miracle-Gro or a balanced fertilizer, water-soluble fertilizer. And as a matter of fact, if you really want it to get big and you want a lot of blossoms, double up the dosage of fertilizer. So rather than having 1 tablespoon per gallon of water, you're going to put 2. And don't be afraid of burning the roots. I've never seen that happen. Fertilizers seem to be processed different these days. And as I said, I recommend Miracle-Gro. Swear by it. I've already done this 3 times. I've already gone around the edge of this plant when it was a little tiny plant, and then when it went into that bigger hanger, and now I'm doing it again right now. And see, we're just gonna cut that right off. You know, come July, this plant will probably be somewhere down around here. Come August, you're gonna have to trim it back with a grass trimmer, a string trimmer or something. If you get it to September, which you should be able to, these things should be spectacular, freakishly huge by September, if you take proper care of it. It'll be this high, there'll be hummingbirds coming around this thing all the time, butterflies sitting on it. You'll be the envy of the neighborhood.